Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Dr. Joyce Brothers. Richard Dawson. And from the Bob Newhart Show, Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene River.
Thank you, friends. They look like a lively bunch, aren't they? Okay.
You look good. Just terrific.
Thank you. Wow. Well, how kind of you to notice.
Trey chic, hon.
What they're all wearing. I'm sorry. Didn't mean to do that. Are you all ready?
Yeah. Ready.
Are you all right?
No, I'm not. What do you say we welcome Billie Jean Travers and Jim Burton?
Sure.
How you feel?
Better.
Billie Jean has won one game. And she stubbed her toe on the way to the big money, the $5,000 bundle. But she's got her $100, and now she's going to be challenged by Jim Burton here. We haven't officially met him. We greet you, we welcome you, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, I'm a school teacher, and I live with three gorgeous girls, a blonde, a brunette, and a redhead, and Elizabeth, Jessica, and my wife, Mary.
Okay. Had me going there for a minute, Jim. Not too long. Now, what do you teach in school?
I teach physical education and driver training at the high school level.
Physical education while you're doing driver training. That's interesting.
Yeah, it is interesting. It's...
What's this? Hop, two, three, shift.
Wonderful.
They usually do it on two, though. That's the only problem.
What's that?
I said they usually do it on two.
Do it on two, yeah. Okay, Jim. Good luck anyway. You may have A or B, sir.
I'll go B for boy.
B for boy. Yeah.
What happened to those three beautiful girls?
You want to go to a commercial?
I don't know. I just asked you.
All right, we'll go to a commercial. I'll put the thing back.
I just usually do.
Go to a commercial, like you always do. Do I have to tell you everything?
Need your lawn mowed? There's a whammy for that. Want to walk the dog? There's a whammy for that. But if you want to win... There's no whammy for that.
No whammy! No whammy! Uh-oh!
Oh, no. Yes.
Oh!
Big bucks!
Pesky little critters.
It's a wipeout!
Press your luck. Tonight at 6 on BUZZR. Let's play.
You want A or B, Jim?
B.
Oh, B.
B for boy.
B for boy. Yes. Oh, all right.
Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. I just had a memory lapse there.
It's much better to put the commercial there.
Right, I think so.
Breaks up.
It's a short one anyway.
Yeah.
Bucktooth Betty is so bucktoothed.
Well,
it's one in every crowd, isn't there?
You tell them, fat lady.
Bucktooth Betty is so bucktoothed without bending her neck, she can scratch her blank with her teeth. That's how Bucktooth Betty is.
Good gravy, Marie. Right.
You look stricken.
It's an unusual image.
Yes, get the picture clearly now.
Yes.
Bucktooth Betty.
Bucktooth Betty.
So bucktooth she can scratch her blank.
Without bending her neck.
Without bending her neck.
Yep. Or without bending her neck.
She can scratch her. Right, all right. Okay. What are the rest of you doing?
Well, I've been thinking about it. I've been trying to visualize it, darling. I have this visual mind, and it's all wonderful.
Yes. Santa is watching. Okay. Here we go. Jim Burton, have you been thinking about it?
Yes.
There it is. Bucktooth Betty is so bucktoothed, without bending her neck, she can scratch her blank with her teeth.
Nose.
No, wait a minute, hold on. He may not understand what bucktooth means. You know what buckteeth are?
Yeah.
It is a malocclusion in which the upper mandible protrudes beyond the lower mandible.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Now for my next number.
Can't change it.
No, too late to change it.
Oh, Gene, that was heavy, you know? You know where I'm coming from?
What does Mortimer Snerd have to say, speaking of Bucktooth?
She not only had big teeth, she was enlarged elsewhere.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and boy, she really did a number.
Is she Bucktooth? Got the idea now. Got the picture, Jim. Brett.
I pictured her as a kind of chubby little person and cute and adorable and everything. And I said she could scratch the dimple in her cleavage.
That's interesting. Very good and imaginative, Charles.
And adorable it smells. I said a husband.
Huh?
Without Thanks. Bending her neck, she can scratch her husband with her teeth. Well, we're getting some interesting responses here, Jim. Nothing to match yours, of course. And don't expect it, but we have to go through the routine anyway. What do you say, Joyce?
I wish you didn't have to. Can I just resign?
No,
from
you
the
gotta
program?
See it. Then.
You gotta. You gotta.
No, if
see
you want
it.
The money, you gotta show your card.
Oh God!
Scratch your belly.
What did she say?
Belly, she said. That
they
is a bucktooth lady.
Very lumpy.
Yeah. All right.
El Lego.
El Lego. Oh dear. That's,
oh dear.
That's a big tooth lady.
I have a tasteful answer.
Good.
You can always count on me for a tasteful
Naturally.
Answer.
Not necessarily.
Wrong. We have a tasteful, wrong answer, my attorneys. Chin.
Chin. He said nose. All right. Hit it everywhere, but no nose there. Now, Billie Jean, this is yours. Listen carefully. Angela said,
"Yeah."
I just won a beauty contest held by the Beef Raisers of America. But... Beef? I hate my new title,
Beef
Raisers of America. But she said, but I hate my new title. Everyone calls me Miss Blank.
Cute.
Beauty contest held by the Beef Raisers of America.
I get it, honey, and I love my answer, and I haven't even written it down, and I'm not letting
right.
anybody see it. The person on my left.
But you don't mind if Bill copies.
No.
What is the final line of the question?
I hate my new title. Everyone calls me Miss Blank. The operative
See,
words are...
He doesn't have me to copy from,
Shut up.
Darling Al. It doesn't happen.
The operative words are Beef Raisers of America.
He's nodded off.
Goodbye, Charles.
Oh.
Billie Jean Travers. 1 second there, while she's changing her mind, while Charles is writing an answer. Angela said, I just won a beauty contest held by the Beef Raisers of America, but I hate my new title. Everyone calls me Miss Blank.
Miss Heifer?
Miss Heifer. Hey, that's pretty good.
That is the cow, right?
Right. That's a rather pixiest little good little answer there she gave us. Miss Heifer.
I can't spell heifer. So, I put bull.
I see. Everyone calls me Miss Bull.
Bull blank.
Yes.
I rarely say that I have the definitive answer, but I think this
do.
One is. That's true. That's why I rarely say it. They call her Mistake.
Yeah. Mistake. Yeah.
We'll play on words, don't you?
Right.
Know?
That is the definitive answer. I must admit
Mistake.
That.
Mistake.
Mistake. Yes. Got the idea?
I hope it's a match. Cow.
Miss Cow. Cow and heifer. Let's see now. A heifer. What is a heifer? Is a heifer a young cow?
Yeah.
Joyce, what do you say?
I said cow.
That's two for her. She says, I hate my new title. Everyone calls me Miss
Steak.
Steak. S-T-E-A-K, you see. A little play on mistake there.
Do you know
yes.
that I had the definitive answer and threw it out?
You didn't.
Do you suppose I've hit my peak and missed it?
Yes.
God, I hope not. Cow.
Cow. There it is. Got the end of round one. 3-0. Favor the champ. Jim, you'll go to work and you'll do a little bit better with the next one. Right now, this for you. Here we are, all ready to carry on. Second and final round. Jim, A or B?
B again.
B again, okay. Wait a minute.
Careful, sweetheart.
That thing gets, I got a little coupling on my microphone that gets hung up once in a while. At the baseball stadium, when horrible Hank walked onto the field...
How far did he walk?
Ah, shut up.
How far did he walk?
Get out. At the baseball stadium, as I was saying, when horrible Hank walked onto the field, it was the first time in baseball history that an umpire called a game on account of blank. Horrible Hank.
Can I have
walked onto the field, first time in history that an umpire called a game on account of blank. That's how horrible, horrible Hank was. Never happened before in the history of the game.
Is there any answer?
Yeah, there are a couple of good ones.
There is for people with intelligence.
Well, that lets you out, doesn't it?
Be friendly.
Let me see.
Now, just...
Now, you call...
He walked onto the field.
Right. It was
and
the first time...
And the umpire had to call the game off and dismiss everybody. First time a game called... Game called on account of blank. Horrible Hank are the operative words.
Isn't it wonderful to know there's a doctor only a tear away?
I can't think of anything. Okay, you're going to have to skip.
Well, give her some help there now.
Come
don't
on,
let
no.
her sit there and.
Put on your
Bill, give her some help
the
there.
Day.
I'm not any help. I couldn't think of anything either.
Poor girl needs help.
That's a terrible question.
It is. At the baseball stadium, when Horrible Hank walked onto the field, it was the first time in the history of baseball that an umpire had called a game on account of...
Nobody showed.
I guess it is a terrible question.
Poor thing, it's a terrible question.
Now, you don't quite understand it either. You didn't understand it either, did you?
I think we're going to make it unanimous.
What?
He's teaching kids how to drive.
Yes. Holy mackerel.
That's terrifying thought.
Wow. Show it.
I think it's going to be unanimous. I think we all missed it. No, you know they call games on account of rain?
Right.
Okay, this guy was so bad, he inflicted so much sorrow on the fans, they call it on account of pain.
You didn't understand it either.
True.
Now, we know you didn't understand it, but what'd you write?
I think that's the worst bloody question we've ever had in the many years we have been doing this show. And I'm with Jim. Never mind, sweetness. It's me and you. I said the smell.
Yeah. Happens to be the definitive answer.
Oh, my gosh, you got him, didn't know it?
Yes. Gets the definitive answer and doesn't know it.
Well, you don't have to smell because you're horrible.
Well, that horrible Hank is the tradition around here. He's a terrible creature, yeah.
Oh, I see.
Charles?
Moving right along, B.O.
B.O. What'd you say, Joyce?
Stopping to a screeching halt, I said disgust.
Disgust. All right. That means Billie Jean Travers wins the game. What'd you have there? Address and rudeness. So come on down, Billie Jean. Going to your accustomed place there. Well, Jim, the trip wasn't a total loss because you do have some gifts coming your way. We thank you for being with us here on Match Game 78. Jim Burke, ladies and gentlemen, good luck to you. Here it is again, Billie Jean. It's all yours. You can win over $5,000. Remember how it goes. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said write down your best answer to this. Care blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave most frequently, remember, you get $500. And then for matching the second most frequent response, you get $250 and $100 for the third, and three of our six will help you.
Okay, Brett.
What about care package?
Okay, there's one.
And Charles.
Carefree.
Carefree.
And Richard.
Careful.
Careful. You have careful, carefree, and care package. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I thought of careful, so I'll stay with Richard.
All right. Some disagree. What would you say? Package. All right. Let's see what we got up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Caretaker. All right. Let's see if we got careful up there anywhere by revealing the $250 response. Carefree. All right, last chance for careful. You can't watch?
No, no.
You're not going to watch?
No.
All right, I'm going to watch because I got to know what's going on here. Slide it. Care package up there, number one. All right. That's twice you've done this to us now.
Right?
We go through all this anxiety here and our hearts get palpitating. And now you pick up another $100. You got $200. You're going to meet another player after we do a little business with America. Yes, it is. You'll be here forever.
Let's play Guess What's Next. This next show premiered July 12, 1976. Currently, over 50 countries air their own version. Do you know what's on next? Stay tuned. What's up next? If you guessed Family Feud, you're right. Next year, Family Feud will celebrate 40 years on the air. But you can celebrate next just by watching.
Today's consolation prize is our first, Bedside. New idea in bed covering provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses and box springs and protection for new from Bedside. And Todman Country Tableware by Washington Ford. Beautiful Fleetwood handles and mirror bright stainless steel dishwasher safe from Washington Ford. And be everything you can be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skin care and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics. And a set of bath towels and a supply of Stay Puff Pink Fabric Softener leaves you washable softer and fresh, towels more absorbent. Stay Puff Pink, the soft, absorbent washable. Here we go again, the Gene Rick.
Thank you very much, Johnny. Also, let's all welcome Terry Jones.
Hello, Terry.
Find out a little bit about you before we begin. Tell us anything you wish.
Well, I'm a homemaker from Northridge, and I've been married for 6 happy years. And I've got 2 small little boys that keep me very busy. Brett, 4, and Brock, 2.
What's the first one's name?
Brett.
Brett?
Yes.
You have a boy named Brett?
Yes, it is. Spelled the same way.
Spelled the same way.
Uh-huh.
Really? Okay. That's interesting. Bret Hart spelled it with 1 T, didn't he?
That's right.
Great short story writer there. Brett, good luck. Terry Jones, you may have A or B.
B.
B it is. This is it. Ben said, using cash to pay for things is almost in the past. Today, I saw a blank that accepted credit cards.
You got it.
Naturally, she had it.
All right. You're thinking. I see you've got your thinking cap on. As soon as they're finished over there, we'll give it to you, and away we go. Ready, Charles?
He's changing his mind.
Oh, all right. Let me just read it to you while he's writing. Ben said, using cash to pay for things is almost in the past. Today, I saw a blank that accepted credit cards. What do you say to that? Using cash to pay for things almost in the past. Today, I saw a blank that accepted credit cards.
Shh. Hush. Would you tell those people to be quiet?
Sorry.
Hey, we talking too loud for you out here? Who's talking back there? Cool it. Thank you. Well, tell them. You're running a thing back here. Hello. We're one big happy family. Did you think of an answer? I'm stalling for you, Terry.
Well, the only thing I can think of is bank.
Bank?
Bank. I can't think of
it.
Oh, boo.
All right. I can tell you in advance you're not going to see the answer bank here. What do you say?
I have a dirty mind. I said a happy hooker.
Happy hooker.
Thank you. I have a dirty mind here today.
What do you say?
It's on Little Santa Monica between Crescent and Cannon Drive. Your parking meter.
Your parking meter.
Oh, cute.
That's
Brad.
A good one. Yeah.
I said a lady of the evening.
Okay. Now, Joyce.
It's called Cash and Carrying On, Hooker.
That's right. Today I saw a bank that accepted credit cards.
Panhandler.
A manhandler.
Panhandler. Oh, I enjoyed that.
Yes. I like that, Diggy.
So easily entertained.
Right.
Lady of the evening, knee hooker.
All right. Okay, Terry, now you know how the game is played, and you'll have one more shot at it. Let's see what we have for Billie Jean Travers here. Did you hear what happened at the medical research lab?
No.
What happened?
Oh, a group of researchers named a blank after Howard Cosell. A group of researchers named a blank after Howard Cosell.
Let me say.
You can take it on absolute authority. That is exactly what they did. Named a blank after Howard Cosell.
Look at my answer. Did you help me when we earlier on? No, I did not help.
This is in bad taste, my answer.
Well, what else is new? Oh, that's
terrible.
No,
it's terrible. It's in bad taste, and I will not tarnish the network with this.
Well, tarnish it with something, kid.
Doesn't say what kind of research lab, just says a research lab.
Yes, it says a medical research lab. Research lab.
There were doctors there.
Group of researchers named a blank after Howard Cosell. Goodbye, Charlie.
You see that sign over there, Charles? Yes. Little sign over there says speed
Producer
up.
Is having a fit throw over that speed up sign, Charles. Billie Jean, did you hear what happened at the medical research lab? I will tell you what happened. A group of medical researchers named a blank after Howard Cosell.
A disease.
Show it.
A disease.
And one for Billie Jean. Brett.
Well, I was going to pick on Charles's answer until I heard hers. Hers is terrific. I said a bull.
Named a bull.
My answer stinks.
Not as bad as hers.
A specimen alligator.
A specimen alligator. Terrific.
Because he has a big
mouth. Yeah, we have two really bad ones there. What do you say, Joyce?
I got a third bad one, a rat.
Rats are used in those laboratories.
And monkeys.
And monkeys, too. Right.
Bulls, you don't
are you listening, Howard?
A germ.
There it is, 1-0 in the end of round one. Now we've got this message for you. Gene Weber, join us next time, Match Game 78. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.